Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So, we have studied what is velocity, potential function and streamline function. Now, we are going to study the same thing in cylindrical coordinate system. So, let us study velocity, potential function in cylindrical coordinate. Now, velocity potential function is given as phi. Now, in cylindrical coordinate, okay, that is r, theta, z, we have to calculate the velocity potential function. But in our fluid mechanics, we are going to study only velocity potential function for r as well as theta. So, if you differentiate dou phi by dou r, then it will give you the value that is ur. Similarly, if you differentiate dou phi by dou theta, it will give a value of r into u theta. So now, this can be also written as u theta is equals to 1 upon r dou phi by dou theta. Now, we have already studied what is rotational flow and irrotational flow. For that, we have seen that is omega is equals to omega x I cap plus omega y j cap plus omega z k cap. So, this can be written as determinant of that is I j k u v w dou by dou x dou by dou y as well as dou by dou z. So this is a equation to determine whether the flow is a rotational flow or an irrotational flow. So now let us see this equation as in relation of velocity potential function. So for value of omega z, we can write omega z as that is 1 upon 2. So, we are calculating omega z. So, for omega z, this two part should be covered. So, what you get over here is dou u by dou y minus dou v by dou x. And this will be of course always multiplied by half. So, now this is half that is dou u by dou y minus dou v by dou x. So that is value of omega z. So now let us calculate this part, rotational and irrotational flow, in the form of a velocity potential function. Now, velocity potential function in rectangular coordinate, that is in rectangular coordinate, your phi can be given as u is equals to minus dou phi by dou x and v is given by minus dou phi by dou y. So let us substitute this value in this equation. Omega z is equals to half into dou by dou y. Instead of u, you have to substitute dou phi by dou x. So this will be dou phi by dou x minus of dou by dou x. Instead of v, we have to substitute that is minus of dou phi by dou y. Here also there will be a negative sign. So now, what do you get over here? This is in a bracket. So this is half into dou square phi, that is negative, into dou y dou x plus dou square phi upon dou x dou y. So this will be for an which flow? That is any flow that might be a rotational flow or irrotational flow. If this is an irrotational flow, then this part will be zero. For an rotational flow, it will have some value of omega z. Now, over here, we can write for rotational and irrotational flow. For rotational flow, now what is rotational flow? That is flow of the fluid in which it is rotating about its own axis. So that means your omega z won't be equals to zero. If omega z is not equals to zero, that means you can write this as dou phi by dou y dou x is not equals to positive of dou phi by dou y dou x dou y. And for irrotational flow, irrotational flow, what we get over here is omega z is equals to zero. Now if omega z is equals to zero, then these two parts are equals to zero. So this will give us dou square phi by dou y dou x is equals to dou square phi by dou x dou y. I hope you have understood what is relation of streamline flow. I hope you have understood what is relation of velocity potential function with cylindrical coordinates and its application in rotational flow and irrotational flow. So let us see now what is relation of streamline function in cylindrical coordinate. Define streamline function as phi. Now we have already defined what is we can define streamline function as psi. Now we have already have defined streamline function in rectangular coordinates. Now we are going to define in cylindrical coordinates. So now this psi, when you differentiate with respect to r, that is dou psi by dou r, it gives us minus of u theta. And if you differentiate this psi by dou theta, this will give you 1 upon r is equals to u r. So now this is how we differentiate, or what this is, what is the relation of your streamline function with your u theta as well as u r. U theta is the tangential velocity or angular velocity along theta direction. Rather, we'll keep that as tangential velocity. And U r is actually what is your radial velocity. Now, let us see the same relation with respect to what is rotational flow and irrotational flow. So, now, for rectangular coordinates, for rectangular coordinate system, phi is defined as dou phi, dou psi by dou x is equals to, that is v, as well as dou psi by dou y is equals to minus u. Now, to check whether a flow is a rotational flow or an irrotational flow, we have to consider the value of omega z. Now, since this entire thing is in two dimension, this is also in two dimension. So we will have only omega z, not omega x and omega y. So now, what is omega z equals to? That is half dou v by dou x minus dou u by dou y. Now, let us substitute the value of V as well as U in this equation. So now let us substitute this part as omega z is equals to half dou by dou x of V. Now V is equals to dou psi by dou x minus of dou by dou y of U, that is given as minus dou psi by dou y. So this completes the bracket. Let us see what do we get over here. Now omega z will be equals to, now omega z will be equals to half of dou square psi by dou x square, because it is differentiated with x twice, plus what we'll get, dou square psi by dou y square. And this is what is the equation to determine whether the flow will be rotational flow or irrotational flow. Now the condition for rotational or irrotational flow will be, if omega z is equals to 0, then it will be called as irrotational flow. And if omega z is not equals to 0, then the flow will be called as rotational flow. So now let us check this out. Okay, so if omega z is 0, then what do we get over here? Minus of dou square phi by dou x square is equals to dou square psi by dou y square. So this is a condition for irrotational flow with respect to a streamline function. Similarly, if omega z is not equals to 0, that means minus of dou square psi by dou x square shouldn't be equals to dou square psi by dou y square. Now, this is the condition for rotational flow in with respect to a streamline function. So I hope you have understood the relation of streamline function and velocity potential function in cylindrical coordinates, and its also application in rotational flow and irrotational flow. Thank you.